Hey guys, welcome to the Playhouse and our summer roundup. I'd like to say a big howdy to you.
Howdy to you too.
Man, you know, we've been learning all summer long about how we can trust in God.
Who can trust in God?
I can trust God.
Who can trust God?
You can trust God.
Wait, you can trust God?
Yeah, and you and you.
And I?
And you.
Can trust God.
And you. Wow. Yep. We, collectively, can trust God.
That's so cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, hey. Reminds me of something that the Lord tells us.
Isn't it in the Bible?
Yep. And all the words in the Bible are true.
Like big T.
Like you can stick them in your heart and believe it.
Because it's real.
Yeah.
God means it.
Uh-huh. And it goes like this. Trust
in the Lord with all your heart. Proverbs 3:5.
The key here is when you trust in the Lord.
Trust in the
Lord.
Yeah,
there's because there are a lot of things you could put your trust in.
Mm-hmm.
You put your trust in a seat when you sit down.
Mm-hmm.
In the same way, you put your trust in the Lord.
So like he's going to catch me.
Right. He's holding you. You can put your trust in the Lord with all your heart.
With all your heart. Mm-hmm. That's so cool.
Well, I think it's time to sing a song about it.
Ooh, let's call out the worship team.
A worship team.
We need everybody at home to hop up and get ready. Let's sing along together. You ready? Here we go.
1, 2, 3. Come hit the trail with me. Let's get on down and round it up, 'cause we can trust in God. No matter what. Here we go now. 3, 2, 1. It's time to have some fun. So sing along now, everyone. When it's bad, I can trust over here, trust over there. I can trust in God everywhere.
Everywhere.
I can trust when I'm happy, and trust when I'm sad. Trust when it's good, and when it's bad, I can trust over here, and trust over there. We can trust in God everywhere. I can trust in God.
What an amazing song that is. And I love so much that it's all about trusting in God.
Yeah.
You know, speaking of which, I heard that maybe the story today is got some animals in it. You know, some animals that you probably wouldn't see on the prairie.
A hamster?
Maybe that one too, but this particular animal in this particular story in the book of Daniel goes roar!
You talk about unicorns?
Maybe I've never heard a unicorn roar.
Oh, you're right.
I was thinking about. Well, I don't want to give it
away. They gotta find out themselves.
All right. Well, let's head on over and learn what we learn from the Bible story today.
One, two, three. Come hit the trail with me. Let's get on down and round it up, 'cause we can trust in God. I can trust.
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome. My name is Marwan, and this is Trusty. And we're so excited you're here for Waumba Land Online. And I am so excited to be here hanging out in the Rootin' Tootin' Roundup. And you know, to get started with the Roundup, the first thing we do is a big howdy. That's right. That's how we say hi in the Roundup. You can do it too. Ready? One, two, three. Howdy. And you know, one of my favorite things about hanging out in the Roundup is getting all dressed up. I bet you got dressed up too. Did you get your boots? I did. And how about your bandanas? I bet you've got some great bandanas. And don't forget your cowboy hat. Yeehaw! Oh, that's right. That's perfect. Well, you know, we've got a lot of fun things to do here in the Roundup, right? We've got an amazing Bible story, and we've got some super fun music. And you know what? I was just thinking, you've seen a lot of the animals here on the Roundup, like the horses and the cows and the pigs, right? But today, I've got a test for you. That's right. Let's wander around the Roundup and see what other animals we see. I bet there's all kinds of animals out there. So you better listen very, very closely and look all around, okay? Let's start walking around and see. Oh, listen up. Listen. Did you hear that? Oh my goodness. It's a rattlesnake. That's right. That's Sammy the snake. Good job. Well, let's keep wandering around and seeing what else we see. Oh, wow. Oh, it's Cody the coyote. Can you howl like Cody the coyote? Go, oh, oh. Good job, boys and girls. You're doing a great job. Oh, let's go on. Let's see what else we hear. What else we see? Oh, did you see it too? I did. I saw it. That's a huge vulture. Can you spread your wings like that? A huge vulture. Those love to fly all around the Roundup. Great job, boys and girls. Let's keep looking and listening, okay? Did you hear that? That's Mama, the mountain lion. That's right. She loves her cubs, though, so you don't want to get too close, okay? You're doing a great job, boys and girls. We've got one last one. Let's keep looking and let's keep listening. Oh, did you hear it? Did you hear it? That's right, that's David the donkey. Boys and girls, I am so proud of you. You got to see so many fun things here on the Roundup. You did a great job. And now it's time for our Bible story. Are you ready? Get your arms up. Okay, here we go. Round them up and round them down. Lasso it around. Give your hat a quiet tap and put it right down in your lap. Great job.
Hey everybody, I am Daniel and I am so excited. I just got finished reading one of my favorite books. Do you know what I'm talking about? It's the Bible. And the Bible is so awesome because it lets us know how much God loves us. And when I was reading the Bible, I came across a man who has the exact same name as me, Daniel. And Daniel loved God so much and he knew that God loved him. And I was so excited that I grabbed my toys and I wanted to show you. So Daniel loved God very much, and he knew that he could trust God. He loved God so much that he prayed 3 times a day. 3 times every day. That is amazing. there is also a king where Daniel lived.
I am the king.
And he really liked Daniel and wanted to put him in charge of everything.
Daniel is my favorite. I want to put him in charge of everything.
There was also some other men that worked for the king, and they didn't like Daniel so much. They were jealous of Daniel.
I don't like Daniel very much. I don't like that he is the king's favorite.
So they tricked the king into passing a law that said that no one could pray to God, that people could only pray to the king.
People should only pray to the king. Yeah, no one can pray to God.
And the law said that if anyone got caught praying to God, that they would be thrown into a den full of lions. That is scary sounding, right? Can you make a scary face? Like this. Like, that is scary, right? A den full of lions. So what do you think Daniel did? Did he stop praying to God?
No,
Daniel loved God. And he knew that God wanted to talk to him every day. So, when Daniel got home that day, he did the same thing that he always did. He talked to God and he thanked him. He prayed to God 3 times, just like he always did. Because Daniel loved God so much, and he knew that whatever happened, that God would be with him, even if he got into trouble. So, the other men saw that Daniel had prayed to God, and they went and told the king. And when the king found out, he was very upset.
I am upset.
And because of that, he had to throw Daniel into the den full of lions.
Daniel, you must go to the den of lions.
So Daniel had to go into a den full of lions all night long. And here's the thing, it's a den, and it's probably really dark, and it's full of lions. And lions are pretty scary, right? I mean, they are loud. It's scary and roary. Can you make a sound like a lion? You know, like, roar!
Roar! Roar!
That's scary. And Daniel was there alone in the dark in a den full of lions. So the next morning, the king rushed to the den to see what had happened to Daniel. And he said,
Daniel, are you okay?
But here's the cool part. Daniel was okay. There wasn't even one scratch on him. Daniel told the king that God had kept him safe. Wow, Daniel did the right thing and trusted God even though he knew it was tough. He continued to pray to God every day, even though that he knew he would get in trouble. And guess what? You can be like Daniel and trust in God and do the right thing. Like, when you accidentally hurt one of your friend's feelings and you need to say you're sorry, you can trust God will help you do the right thing and say you're sorry. Or when you have a new toy and your mom tells you to share with your brother or sister, you can trust God will help you do the right thing and share. You can trust God and I can trust God. So let's pray to God and thank Him for loving us and for helping us do the right thing. Dear God, thank you for loving us. And thank you for helping us remember that we can do the right thing, just like Daniel. Amen. See, it's pretty amazing. And it's pretty awesome that I share a name with Daniel that's really gonna help me remember that I can do anything even though it's tough and that I can always trust God.
Welcome to the Waumba Roundup.
Wow, that was a crazy story.
It's a lion. In a hole.
Like, a lot of them.
Like, real teeth, real hungry lion.
Roar. I can't think of anything that I've ever had to do that's as scary as being in a hole with lions.
Yeah, but we do have some scary things that we go through a lot of times.
Yeah.
Even though they're not lion related, I'll tell you one big roar that makes me a little bit nervous.
What?
The roar of thunder.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thunder
scares me. When the
thunder rolls.
Mm-hmm. Especially mm-hmm. when the wind is blowing. I'm always scared that something scary is going to happen.
Yeah, but just like Daniel in the lion's den, he knew something that we also know.
We can trust God.
We can trust God.
We can trust God. Who can trust God?
I can trust God.
Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah. Well, so cool. You know what? With that truth, makes me think it's time for us to round them on up and move them out. You know, it is the last week of our summer roundup, but we're so excited you'll join us. See you next week.
Bye. Friends, he's a good, good friend. He's a good